Mr. Chairman, members of the board, the next item is a request by me for the board to consider a waiver of conflict with respect to my law firm and Turner Winter Joint Venture. I have placed a proposed resolution regarding that apparent conflict, and I will explain it in detail if you will add it to the agenda. But if you'll just add it to the agenda and give an opportunity to explain what the situation is.
Which part of the agenda?
That would be the next item on new business.
New business number six, I move. I stand, I so move.
Got a motion and a second. There's no further discussion. Please vote. That passes unanimously.
Chairman, it's just my night tonight. The next issue pertains to the Social Services Committee and the Board of Commissioners making a recommendation for a funding with respect to social services and certain nonprofits. Mr. Chairman, I request the board take up as the next new business item a waiver of conflict between myself and my law firm with respect to my limited and time-to-time representation of CASA. I would ask the board to at least hear my concerns on that and consider it. Mr. Chairman, that will take a 4-5.
Back. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote. That passes unanimously. Item number 5, a resolution appointing county attorney for the period of December 31st, 2012 through December 31st, 2014.
Yes, Mr. Chairman and Commissioners, I'm standing in this evening for County Manager Doug Dare. You have in your agenda book a copy of a resolution for your consideration for a 2-year term contract for Jarrard and Davis for legal services for the county.
Thank you. What is the pleasure of the board on this item?
It would be my pleasure to make a motion that we accept the resolution appointing the county attorney as presented in this agreement.
Second.
We have a motion. We have a second. If there's no discussion, please vote. That passes unanimously. Thank you, Mr. Jarrard, for all your service to the county.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
So you look a little bit giddy.
I'm sorry that you added so much to the agenda tonight, however.
Gotta
get it in while I still have a job. Well, that's right. All right. Let's see. Under new business, the items that I saw was to add, and I'm not sure I got this right, a waiver of conflict. The next item I have is a waiver of conflict regarding term.
It is, Mr. Chairman. This is in front of you on your station. You should see a waiver of conflict document that looks like in the second paragraph says Winter Turner Joint Venture. That is the document I want you to look at this evening. This is information based upon information I learned yesterday. I think in the previous agenda item I mentioned that I was working with procurement on the construction manager at risk contract that I hope to be able to bring to you in January. Well, we had a large meeting about that with procurement staff yesterday and representatives of Turner Winter Joint Venture, who of course you have selected to be the construction manager at risk, for working through the 120-page contract a page at a time, it would seem. And in the course of that, I learned yesterday they have assembled on their side only a project team. And this is not a team that the county will be entering into a contract with, but I think it's just part of their team of qualified individuals that they may or may not be using. They may in fact use one of these individuals as subcontractors, but they attended the meeting yesterday and they're bound by me that I need to go ahead and request a waiver of conflict because one of the individuals is a principal in the firm of J.K. Lockwood Construction. That principal is Joe Lockwood. Joe Lockwood is the mayor of the city of Milton. My law firm represents the city of Milton. So I found out about that yesterday, and again, I want to emphasize to you that the county is not entering into an agreement with J.K. Lockwood Construction. And of course, that has no bearing whatsoever on my ability to zealously represent the county's interest in the contract negotiation. However, out of an abundance of caution, I felt it only appropriately that I disclose this in an open session and request that you waive any appearance of impropriety that may arise because someone could say, because Joe Lockwood and his company are part of the project team, that you may somehow have a divided interest. Mr. Chairman, that's my report.
Thank you. What's the pleasure of the board?
Mr. Chairman, make a motion that we accept the waiver of conflict. Presented to us by council.
Sir.
We have a motion, we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote. And that passes unanimously. I think we are now talking about social services.
Mr. Chairman, that's just my night. This is a little bit unusual. We're going to have two requests for a waiver of conflict in the same meeting, but you have to call them the way you see them. Earlier this evening, the Board of Commissioners approved various grants to certain 501c3 entities as part of the Social Services Committee recommendations of the Board trying to provide services to the juvenile court and for other reasons. One of the entities that received or will receive funding is CASA. And what is anticipated by the new way we try and run social services and nonprofits with respect to juvenile court is now we actually have, we're going to have contracts containing milestones and compliance requirements and critical paths and things of that nature. So we're all, I think, very pleased with that. However, in the context of the fact that CASA will be getting some funding, it's incumbent upon me to let you know that while I am not by any stretch on retainer with CASA, from time to time, I have provided legal services to CASA. I am not on the Social Services Committee and certainly don't make any recommendations with respect to who receives funding. But nonetheless, for appearance's sake, appearance of propriety, I wanted to bring this to you in an open session. I wanted to reveal my very limited project-to-project affiliation with CASA and ask that to the extent that even an appearance of impropriety could be asserted that you would respectfully waive that.
Thank you. What's the pleasure of the board?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like the motion to be approved in waiver of conflict presented by council.
Second.
Ian, council.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote. And that passes unanimously. Next item, number 10, I believe, is about brick in the city of Conway.
Mr. Chairman, thank you for that.